But I believe, inshallah, that a person who have this to become, especially the sisters, because of height, I believe they can fast Tasu'a and Ashura with the two attention combining together, to make up for Ramadan and Tasu'a and Ashura, inshallah ta'ala. Mafhoum, ikhwan? Is that clear? Is that clear? Now, Ashura, barakallahu fikum, between يعني two sins, right? We have always the right middle, the correct, as two sins and hasana right in the middle. We have the Shi'a, we have the Nawasib and others, and we have Ahlul Sunnah. Ahlul Sunnah, the people of Haqq, the people of the truth, they do what the Prophet did. We fast. We don't do nothing. We don't wash for that day. If it happens that you want to wash, wash yourself. But we don't glorify more than what it is. We fast. There's nothing else to be done. We don't make that day a special day apart by fasting. We don't do deliberately taking the zakat of that day. That become bid'ah. If it happened, Allah malaka, but do it deliberately, no. We don't cook food in that day. Some people do that. Before? We don't do that. Or give sweets. They have so weak a hadith. He said, the day of Ashura, if you give more to your family, Allah will give you more. All that hadith is da'ifa. There's no hadith that can stand to talk about what we should do apart from fasting. So nothing has been done. There's no the night of Ashura or the day of Ashura or do this or do that. There's nothing you can do apart from fasting. And I'll repeat this. There's no other thing. Is that clear? No other thing. Khalas, ikhwan? There are a lot of bid'ah. Give you examples. Some people believe if you do kuhul, the eyelashes, you know, the kuhul, man and woman. They said, if you do that, this hadith is fabricated. He said, you will not get ill that year. That year, because the beginning of the year, you will never fall ill. Astaghfirullah. Some people say, whoever wash himself in Ashura, he will not get ill. Again, it's not hadith. من وسع على أهله يوم عشرة وسع الله عليه سائر السنة. كذب عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Lie on the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. There's no chicken as people do in some countries, or couscous in some people do. It's a custom. Don't do that. Do not do that. Don't make couscous in that specific day. And the people know what I'm talking about. Or rishta. Rishta is the type of food they do in North Africa is that day. Or put the candles or do things. Don't do anything. Barakallahu fikum. Fast. That's what you should do. Anything else, then you will be held responsible and judged for it in a day of reckoning, because it's a bid'ah. And every bid'ah is misguidance, and every misguidance is in Jahannam. Afanallahu wa iyyakum. Be very careful. Mafhum? Be very careful. Ahlul Sunnah will fast. So some people from the Sunnah, from the people of Ahlul Sunnah, but they won't straight from the Sunnah, they do this. Most of it is a custom. They think this is what it is. And they sing things and so on and so forth. There's those who are even beyond that, we call them al-Nawasib. Al-Nawasib, those who hate the family of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they celebrate that day. Why? Because in that day, al-Hussain, the son of Ali, radiallahu anhu, the cousin of the Prophet, and the son of Fatima, and the nephew of who? Of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was killed in that day. So they celebrate that. And this is wrong 110%. Likewise, the Shia themselves are wrong. Because what they do in the day of Ashura, you can see that they were black. They start beating themselves. They start saying poetry, lying, crying, cursing the Sahaba, saying shirkiyat. Shirkiyat. Things that would take you out of Islam. Lies, innovations, fabricated a hadith. We Ahlul Sunnah, of course, we are sad. And Hussain is a martyr and is a master of the youth in Jannah. We know that. We have more praise of the Hussain in the Sunnah than the Shia themselves. They think they follow in Hussain. They don't follow in Hussain. Because I know you know how was he killed. I'll give you a little summary. Muawiyah radiallahu anhu wa arzah, after the death of Ali, he took over. He became a Khalifa. He's a Sahabi radiallahu anhu wa arzah. We love him. And he's a Sahabi. Before Hassan radiallahu anhu, he said, I don't want any of this. He pledged allegiance to who? To Muawiyah radiallahu anhu. So is Hussein. When Muawiyah, before he died, they appointed his son Yazid. The people in Iraq, those who were creating fitna makers, the Shia at that time, they wrote letters to who? To Al-Hussein. We're giving you bay'ah, come, come. Al-Hussein said, he said, Muslim. He said, go and check what's going on. He went there and he was killed. And even though before he was sent someone else, he said to him, don't come, they betray you. Because they said, we are here for you. And if there's mini narration, we don't have much time. There were thousands outside the castle. And within a day or two, the man found himself by himself or someone else with him. So that's what the Shia do. The Shia, they're always like this. They cry and they do all of this. But it was them that brought to Hussein to his death. Al-Hussein didn't know. There was no phones or teletext, whatever you want to call it at that time. So when he arrived, he knew. And even before he left Al-Hussein, the Sahaba told him not to go. Meaning a hadith, a par, should I say. Not a hadith, because a hadith of Prophet. Meaning a par, meaning stories of the great Sahaba, the scholars of the Sahaba, told him, do not go. They told him not to go. But Hussein is a courageous man. He went there. And he was killed. And we can free ourselves from those who killed him. But the Shia need to understand it was them who brought the Hussein in there. And he regretted it for coming there. Because he knew they betrayed him. So we are unhappy, we're sad for the death of Hussein. But we're not going to make a day to slap our faces and cut our heads to show our love to Hussein. Astaghfirullah. This is like a jahiliyyah. This is what a jahiliyyah do when somebody die from the family, not from the deen. And why is it Hussein only? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam died. Even prophets before Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, other prophets were killed. Why do the Shia do not do that? Why do you not do it on Ali? You understand? You need to be very careful. It's all politically orientated. Nothing to do with the deen. Nothing to do with the religion. Because when you look into the Shia, religion is full of kufr, full of shirkiyat. Some of the corrupted creed of the Shia, for instance. Regardless what happened to Hussein, we said, are we free ourselves from those who killed him? What else do you want? He's in Jannah. If you believe he's in Jannah, why you every year you beat yourself up and make Islam look bad. People don't make a difference between Shia and Sunni. Look Islam, look the Muslims. But those people from the corrupted creed, Afan Allah wa Iyakum, they believe that the Quran is corrupted. Astaghfirullah. It is in their books. And even when someone will come up to you, oh, no, I don't believe that. If you don't believe that, then what is the ruling of somebody that believes the Quran is corrupted? Surely he is a kafir, because he contradicted what Allah says, that we indeed have revealed the Quran dhikr, ay, the Quran is in the dhikr, wa inna lahu lahafidhu, we will preserve it. So by you believing the Quran has been not preserved, then you disbelieve in the Quran, that makes you a kafir. So even if you believe, I'm not going to go into, you know, authority or all of this. No, leave this aside, please. Jazaakumullahu Khayran. Remind me 30 years ago, this is what we used to do to them because they're not aware of it. But now there's other means to explain to the Shia. So if you believe the Quran is not corrupted, then surely you have no problem on making takfir or free yourself from those who said so. نعمت الله الجزائري and so on and so on and others. You need to be very careful. بارك الله فيكم. They make takfir to the Sahaba, to Abu Bakr and Umar and Ali and Uthman and so on and so forth. This is the corrupted creed of the Shia. The corrupted creed of the Shia, they ask others than Allah. They put the A'imma in a higher rank than the Prophet and messengers. They believe the A'imma, they know the unseen. And how stupid can someone be knowing the unseen and Hussain, he's a Imam, not knowing that they betrayed him and he was about to get killed? How silly can you be? Right? Of course, nobody knows the unseen. Mufhum? And all these upon, Ali should be the Khalifa. No, Ali himself in your own book. Tada'uni wal tamisu ghayri. Leave me alone, ask for someone else. And Ali has given allegiance to who? To Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman. He worked for them. Wake up, you Shia. Wake up, you Shia. How could an Imam know when he dies and did not die except with their own will? And in the same time, they said there's no single Imam except he died, being killed or poisoned. But if he knows when he died and it's his choice, what would he choose to die by poison? What would he choose to die killed? Then it becomes suicide. You see how corrupted? Because you may think, Amma, what are you talking about? This is in their books. The book of Kafi, he says, Inna al-a'imma ya'lamuna ma ta'yamutun. وَأَنَّهُمْ لَا يَمُوتُونَ إِلَّا بِاخْتِيَارٍ مِّنْهُمْ. They know when they die. And they have the choice when they die and how they die. In the same time, he said, لَمْ يَكُنْ إِمَامًا إِلَّا مَاتَ مَقْتُولٌ أَوْ مَسْمُومٌ. He will not become an imam till he die, being killed or poisoned. How could you combine the two? See how contradictory that religion is? And I'm sorry, we have to talk about this. It is very important to understand how corrupted their religion is. So that's what the Shia do in Ashura. They sit together. And you know, some of the beliefs, for instance, is based on hatred. For instance, they will not give you to drink water, believing that that's what happened to Hussein and his family and so on and so forth. till you curse the Sahaba. Billahi alaykum. Is that religion? That own Khomeini who revived the religion, every subh he has a famous dua. Allahumma al'an sanama Quraysh. Oh Allah, curse the idols of Quraysh. Wabnatahuma and their daughters. Do you know who he meant by? Abu Bakr wa Umar, Aisha and Hafsa, the wife of the Prophet. How could somebody pretend, claim to be Muslim, cursing the wife of your beloved Prophet? How could somebody be Muslim? You curse the wife of the Prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because nobody can deny. Nobody. Look, I'm not going to go and give you adilla from the books and this and that, please. I'm going to talk to you in the level that anybody can understand it. That Aisha radiallahu anha, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he chose to die on her room. Am I right? Am I wrong? Even up to today, that is her room where the grave of the Prophet, because the Prophet should be buried when he died. You need to understand that. Al-anbiya yudfanun ayna yamutun. When they die, that's when they're going to be buried. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam chose to be buried, not only chose to be buried, he asked other wives if they can let him spend his last days with Aisha radiallahu anha. If he did not love Aisha, if he did not believe that Aisha is just a pious person. The Prophet chose Aisha to die in her room and to spend the last days of his life with her. And you pretend that the Prophet is your messenger and you curse her? No mind, no brain. You can lie till tomorrow. You can bring so many ahadith and we can refute you. That's no problem. But the thing is, this is something that we all agree. Shi'a and Sunnah. Shi'a and Sunnah. Every time you go to the grave of the Prophet ﷺ, where is his grave? Who is buried next to him? Is it Abu Bakr and Umar? Who's buried next to him? What will Ali give his daughter to Umar? Be like Ali, be like Abu Bakr, be like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So this is why the Shia is doing, barakallahu fikum, claiming that the Khulafa were kuffar. A'udhu billah. Do you think Allah Azza wa Jal will let the kafir be buried next to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Ajib. يعني لا عقول لهم. They have no brain, no mind. They don't think right. And that's what they do. So they let you go thirsty and he comes with the water and he only gives you water if you curse Abu Bakr Umar. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. That's what they do in Ashura. And then they claim, oh, this is Ashura, a revolution, and that's what Hussain did, and that's... أخي تقوا الله في أنفسكم. Fear Allah. Fear Allah Azza wa Jal. To give you a story on the side that he was oppressed. Yes, Hussain, radiallahu anhu, Allah, he was oppressed. And we are against those who killed Hussain. And Hussein is being praised more in our deen, in our hadith, than your deen. But he's in Jannah. Other prophets we killed, Sahaba we killed, were taught is Ammar ibn Yasir. He saw his own mother being stabbed and his own father be killed in front of him to the point he couldn't take it. And they asked him to reject the religion of the Prophet. He rejected it by saying, Hubal. And the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, "Fa in adu fa'ud." If they come back and do the same, and Allah revealed the whole verse, except the one who said it, وَقَلْبُهُ مُطْمَئِنٌ بِالْإِيمَانِ. I out of contact, out of fear, you can do so. Why don't you do that about Sumayya, the mother, or Ammar, or Abu Ammar, the father of Ammar ibn Yasir, or Sumayya, radiallahu anha? Why don't you do that? Of course they won't. That's what I say. It is political. Nothing to do with the deen. Those people who come to corrupt. In the time of Ali radiallahu anhu, because the Shia are three parts. Are al-mu'allaha, or al-mu'alliha, the two. Those who used to believe, and some of them still, on Nusayriya of today, that Ali radiallahu anhu is the god is a deity beside Allah. He used to say, Ali, anta hu. Qalu man alu anta al-Rab. Ali used to kill them at that time, and they ran away from him. So Ali used to fight them and they killed them. How could you be given credit allegiance to Ali when Ali himself used to kill you, subhanAllah? That's called al-Mu'allah. And then al-Sababiyya, those who curse the Sahaba, like the Rawafid of today, who said that Abu Bakr is kafir and the curse and so on and so forth. And then the last is a Zaydiyya, which is the closest to the Sunnah. At that time, not every Zaydi is the same. Not every, you know, Sababiyya are the same, or Ja'fariyya or al-Rawafid and so on and so forth. The first one is definitely Kuffar. The second type, most of them are Kuffar. Like al-Rawafid, like al-Ja'fari, and so on and so forth. They're not part of the deen. They're not part of the madhab. How could somebody be a madhab in the deen when he cursed the wife of your beloved prophet? Have you no shame for those who turn to defend them? If somebody cursed your mom or cursed your wife, would you speak to him? Are you cursing the wife of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? Ird al-Nabi, in more beloved to me than my own ird. So, we can refute the Shi'a. Anything that the Shi'a bring, alhamdulillah, is all like water, like ma. It's easy to refute. Visiting the grave of al-Hussain, better than to visit the house of Allah. Having temporary marriage, zawaj al-mut'a, the more you do it, better than Hajj and Umrah. How could this be deen? How could this be a deen, a religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The visit in the grave, better. Even say the grave of Allah and the grave of Hussein, astaghfirullah, is in the arsh of Allah. And the best thing and the greatest thing within the arsh of Allah is the grave of Hussein. That's what I'm saying. You need to understand. The Shia, we're not like, oh, they're talking about the Sahaba. For them, the Shia came before the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Did you know that? Shi'ism for them is before the coming of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because you may say, oh, where did you get this from, you know? why are you saying this? It was them who said that, it's not me. In so many books of the Shi'a, they say there's not a prophet except that he gives allegiance to Ali. How could the Prophet give allegiance to Ali? Even the verses. Before, you know, when we talk about the verses, yeah? And Allah Azza wa Jalla took us as a witness. Sah? For them, the tafsir is what? That this is the allegiance of Ali. And by the way, don't let anybody fool you from the Shia. This is true. If you said, oh, I don't make takfir, because this is one of their games. Even if they don't know, some of them are ignorant, just repeated things. But they say, oh, no. Abu Bakr is Muslim. Are you a Muslim? You know what they mean by Muslim? You need to be very careful. Muslim, it means you're a munafiq. It means I deal with you as a Muslim now, as I am weak. But to me, in the day of judgment, you're a kafir. You will never call Abu Bakr mu'min. They will never call Aisha mu'min or call you mu'min. But they will call Khomeini mu'min. They will call the a'imma mu'minun. I'm not talking about the a'imma, the righteous a'imma. So not everything that they will bring out, we hate those people. No, Hassan and Hussein, they are a'imma. Barakallahu fikum. We're talking about what they believe others than the a'imma, like a Khomeini and... You know, and Ni'mat Allah al-Jazairi, those khubathal who have nothing to do with the deen. For them are believers. But the Sahaba are not believers. So they do play this game. So that's what they do in Ashura. Latm al-Khudud, wa shaq al-Juyub, wa la'n al-Sahaba, and food, and, you know, that's what they do, and they think this is part of the deen. How could this be part of the deen? Wallahi, ikhwan, how could this be part of our religion? In Ashura, that's what they do. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Lakin alhamdulillah, and Allah Azza wa Jalla an'ama أنعم علينا نعمة الإسلام ونعمة السنة ونصطفانا إن شاء الله على كثير من عباده. الحمد لله عفانا الله مما ابتلاهم به وفضلنا على كثير من عباده تفضيلا. الحمد لله دار من نؤداء. الحمد لله that you don't have to do زواج المتعة. الحمد لله that you don't call others than Allah. الحمد لله you don't curse the wife of the prophet or the companions of the prophet. الحمد لله that you don't call others than Allah عز وجل. الحمد لله you don't have to give your khumus, your money, your zakat money, you give it to the a'imma, not for the poor, so for them to keep it for ajaj. We call it ajjal Allah faraj, they say, and they curse al-mahdi al-muntazar. Alhamdulillah, we're not up on this. What we do in Ashura and in Muharram, we fast as many days as we can. We fast Asu'a, we fast Ashura. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to forgive us and to accept it from us. That's the true believer. Should not be fooled by his actions. Should not be fooled by his actions. Should not be, he should not have a big head. And I must say, because some people might think, and this is not me, the ulama says that, barakallahu fikum. Some people might think, because he fasted Ashura, or he fasted Arafat, then all the sins are forgiven, he can do anything he wants. Don't let the shaitan play with you, barakallahu fikum. Don't let the shaitan play with you. It was a statement of the ulama, barakallahu fikum. He said one should not be fooled by this, barakallahu fikum. Mafhum? You do, as Allah described the righteous people, they do things wa qulubuhum wajila, and the heart are full of fear that Allah may not accept it from them. So Allah an yaj'alani wa iyyakum mimman yastami'una al-qawla fayattabi'una ahsana wa yahdiyani wa iyyakum lima ikhtalafna fihi min al-amr وأن يتوب علينا وعليكم ويجعلنا ممن وفقهم الله لصيام هذه الأيام المباركة ونجعلنا من عتقائه من النار وجمعنا الله وإياكم في جنة الرضوان عرضها السماوات الأرض. والله تعالى أعلى وأعلم. وسبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت استغفرك وأتوب إليك. وسبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين الحمد لله رب العالمين والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.